In May 1943, Albert Speer, the Reich Minister of Armaments and War Production, informed Adolf Hitler of work that was being carried out to produce a new supergun capable of firing hundreds of rockets an hour over a long distance. The Fortress of Mimoyecques is the modern name of the Second World War underground military complex built by Nazi Germany between 1943 and 1944. It is located in the Pas-de-Calais region of northern France. It was intended to house a battery of V3 cannons aimed at London, 165 kilometres away. This new weapon was codenamed High Pressure Pump, HDP for short, and then later designated the V3. It was constructed by a German workforce, but Soviet prisoners of war were also used as slave labourers. The complex consisted of a network of tunnels dug under a chalk hill and was linked to 5 incline shafts in which 25 V3 guns would have been installed and were all aimed at central London. The guns would have been able to fire 10 dart-like explosive projectiles a minute, 600 rounds every hour. Winston Churchill later commented, saying that this would have been the most devastated attack of all time. The Allies knew nothing about this V3 rocket, but identified the site as a possible launching base for the V2 ballistic missiles, based on reconnaissance photographs and intelligence from French sources. Mimoyecques was targeted for intensive bombardment by Allied air forces from late 1943 onwards. Construction work was seriously disrupted, forcing the Germans to abandon part of the complex. The rest was partly destroyed on the 6th of July 1944 by the RAF's 617 Squadron, which used ground-penetrating tallboy bombs that were dropped from the plane and reached speeds of 750 miles an hour before burrowing into the ground and then detonating to collapse tunnels and shafts, which resulted in burying hundreds of workers underground. The Germans halted construction work at Mimoyecques as the Allies advanced up the coast following the Normandy landings. It fell to the Canadian 3rd Infantry Division on the 5th of September 1944 without resistance, a few days after the Germans withdrew from the area. More parts of the complex was demolished just after the war by the Royal Engineers on Winston Churchill's direct orders, as it was still seen as a threat to the United Kingdom. It was later reopened by private owners, first in 1969 to serve as a mushroom farm and subsequently as a museum in 1984.